John Mickett is traveling to a beautiful, remote island. He spends hours in the car, hops a ferry, drives some more.
Oh, there's the Pacific Ocean. Check that out.
Arranges a helicopter ride with a satellite phone.
It's ringing.
It's a 13-hour trip, one way, to find a buoy.
Things don't always work as you expect them to.
Unplanned trips to chase wayward buoys is part of life as a physical oceanographer. For 2 decades, Mickett has built complicated floating instruments that take ocean measurements. Last year, this one was bobbing along the Washington coast.
90 miles away, directly in that direction, down to where it used to be. During that time of year when it broke free, the currents are just screaming to the north. I think it just got caught in that current.
In fact, ocean currents carry all sorts of man-made stuff to far-flung places, including untouched beaches, like this one. But most of the stuff isn't like Mickett's buoy. Nobody's spending 3 days to recover it. And Mickett says we need to know about it.
Wow.
Fishing floats.
This guy's a longline float.
Plastic water bottles.
So many water bottles.
And more.
Flip-flops. There's a ball of line. Foam and plastic. Is this a printer toner cartridge? That's an octopus.
And I can look down right here and pick up maybe 5 or 6 pieces of plastic. So this is a very remote, beautiful spot, but it's not untouched by human activity. And the fact that it is so remote, people can't get out here. There's thousands of them on the beach.
Worldwide, we're talking trillions, because every year, 8 million tons of plastic end up in the ocean. In the Pacific Northwest, some of it is coming from as far away as Asia.
You just pick up a random float, it'll have Japanese, Chinese markings. It's coming across the ocean.
The tsunami that struck Japan in 2011 unleashed enough marine debris to prompt a massive cleanup effort on North America's west coast. It took months, $1 million from the Japanese government, and a really big barge. But chasing buoys around, Mickett has seen plenty of other beaches, like this one. And he says cleaning them up is crucial. Big plastic like this becomes small plastic in the future.
It just breaks down to smaller and smaller bits, and it ends up in the food chain.
So the group collects its own debris, a 1,500-pound buoy made of metal and styrofoam, and as much trash as they have room for.
We can't just leave it here.
But without more time and money, they'll have to leave the rest. The wildest places may be difficult to reach for us, but not for our trash.